had something. We didn't know how much or how big or how it would evolve, but we knew we had something. We didn't know how far it was going to go.
From a young age, the blues to me are, you know, they were always my favorite routine. You know, everybody's got to have a favorite. For me, it was the Blue Angels.
We started what they called the Navy Flight Demonstration Team in the spring of 1946. I was fortunate enough to be selected as one of the pilots.
Dan, Jim, and I all love the things that we get to do with these aircraft in different ways, but there's one thing that I know for a fact that we really share in common. That is to be able to share it with the Blues. The current team, hadn't even seen or touched a Bearcat. That's their history, that's their living history, and to get them there and put them up in the aircraft and let them get in there, and some of the guys are so big, you know, they couldn't even get their shoulders inside.
I really didn't know what to expect. I knew that Bearcats were going to be flown in a demonstration. I was going to go down there, be, you know, with my Blue Angel buds. And combining this together was, of course, generations of history between, you know, what airplanes are flown.
It is so exciting that these airplanes are now being seen with the Blue Angels.
And they started out with the Hellcat. That only lasted about 3 months before they upgraded to what's behind me here, the Bearcat. From August of 1946 until 49, this was the airplane that the Blue Angels flew.
We were anticipating getting in a new airplane, and we were hoping we'd get into the Bearcats. And we got orders to go up to Grumman in Bethpage, Long Island, to get four new F-8F aircraft.
Well, the Bearcat is it's the last generation of piston engine aircraft. It's got a different engine. Instead of having a Rolls-Royce Merlin or the Packard-built Merlin, V12, it's a round engine. It's got this, it's called an R2800, but it just goes like hell. I mean, it absolutely goes like hell.
It was an incredible experience to feel that and hear that, because as a Blue Angel, when you're applying to the team especially, you hear and learn a lot about the history of the team. So you knew that they flew the Bearcat, you knew that it was one of their favorite propeller airplanes that they'd ever flown. You'd always heard, you know, the past guys that were on the team talk about how much they love that airplane.
This is exciting to see these old airplanes in such pristine condition. They're just beautiful. Anticipation of getting into that brand new little hot rod was what it was. We were all eager to get in that airplane because we knew it was a fantastic airplane for us especially, but squadron-wise was even better. It was just a better airplane than the F-6F. It was the next step up.
When I touch a Bearcat and then look at the team, it really is for me a feeling of completion, that we know where we came from, we know where we are now, and in between those two points, all the patriotic, hardworking, problem-solving Americans that made that happen. They went into designing these airplanes, making them fly. It's perfect.
I thought I left this behind me when I was flying jets, but I guess the feeling comes back, and it's back stronger than ever because I know it's a thing of the past. But it's fabulous.
And so, you know, just the history of the Blues and knowing that it was something that I loved as a kid, and then knowing that I had this opportunity to actually be in a formation with some of the Blue Angels and having their jets pull up into our formation is just, I can't even describe it. It just, you know, it's unbelievable. It's chilling.
They're going through a lot of different changes here just to fly these Bearcats now along with the F-18s. So there's quite a bit more complication than just seeing the airplanes are showing up here. I mean, these airplanes, they're gorgeous. They look like they should be in a museum, not about to go flying. They look like they've sat here, been painted, been dusted, and you know, have no intention of getting airborne, but these are actually gonna fly here. And with two F-18s, Blue Angels number 5 and 6, your solo pilots, your lead solo and your opposing solo.
We're gonna fly in a Vic, Jimmy, me, Dan, Blue Angel number 5, Blue Angel number 6.
If the air was smooth, easy. But if you got a gust of wind there, you are jockeying the throttle all the time.
As you're tucked up underneath somebody else's wing, and especially in the case of the flying conditions that you're gonna see today, when we've got winds gusting 20 to 30 knots, and there's some texture and airplanes are moving, and they're bouncing, That's a pretty big thing spinning on the front of this airplane. And as the flight lead under there, you've got two wingmen with that propeller bouncing underneath you. It's kind of like having two piranhas, you know, chewing at the side of your airplane. And just hopefully, you know, they don't get too close.
Here's formation of the beginning and the present. To me, that's extremely exciting. It's just very, very exciting. I can't say enough about it. And they all did such a wonderful job. They worked together. They briefed well. They debriefed well. They had it well organized.
That looks pretty good. Pretty good.
I remember looking down from the right side. I was on Jimmy's wing. And Greta was on the left side. And I remember kind of looking down and sort of peripherally seeing the blue and gold come up. And thinking to myself, you better not move. So that was probably the most focused I've ever been in the formation. But it was a very special experience.
I think the sound of the airplane is going to make a difference to me. The sound of that big engine out there, that R2800 that you got going out there, is one thing. But I think that the quickness of the airplane, the way it gets off the ground and the way that it settles down, and how you guys are going to fly it is going to be reminiscent of what we did. And so I'm looking forward to that.
That's a 1946 version of 2009 of the Blue Angels, huh?
And you'd see the Bearcats in formation as they came over the top of the parked six blue F-18s. And just take that one snap image, you know, the history there that was going on, was my favorite memory.
Yeah, it's a nice formation.
Brings back a lot of memories, I'll tell you.
They're having a hell of a time up there.
You think they're having
a lot of time. They're fighting it, but they're having a hell of a time.
Yeah. The wingmen are fighting it.
The leader's doing sitting up there fat, dumb, and happy, you know. He's doing great.
So for us to be able to share that experience is just, that's the ultimate. We love that kind of stuff.
Hey, you guys did a hell of a job.
You think?
You damn right.
We thought about you all the way around.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking about you guys. Physicians, your wingmen are working hard.
Yeah.
But they were there, and they were good, and I was impressed. Boy, this is old times.
Is it?
My last flight in the Bearcat was January 1950. I'm 90 years old, and there's no way I'm going to fly that airplane. But in my mind, I could fly that airplane, and it would thrill me to death to get it off the ground. You know, it's a long time ago.